Before we can think about programming, we need to understand what a program is. In this video, we will be looking at what makes a program, and what are the differences between natural and formal languages. At the end of the video, we'll have a first look at the Python language. A program is a sequence of instructions that specifies how to perform a computation. A few basic instructions appear in just about every procedural and object-oriented programming languages. The first one is input. It gets data from the keyboard, a file, or some other device. The second one is output. Display data on the screen and send that out to a file or the device. The third one is maths. It performs basic mathematical operations like an addition and a multiplication. The fourth one is a conditional execution. It checks for some condition and executes the appropriate sequence of statements. And the last one, finally, is repetition. Repetition performs some action repeatedly, usually with some variation. Believe it or not, that's pretty much all there is to it in every program you have ever used. No matter how complicated the program is, it is made up of instructions that look pretty much like this. So you can think of programming as a process of breaking a large complex task into smaller and smaller subtasks until the subtasks are simple enough to be performed with one of these basic instructions. That may be a little vague, but we will come back to this topic when we talk about algorithm. Natural languages are the languages that people speak, such as English and French. They were not designed by people. They evolve naturally over time. On the other hand, formal languages are languages that are designed by people for specific applications, such as mathematical notation. Formal languages tend to have strict rules about syntax. Syntax rules come in two flavors, patterning to token and structure. Tokens are the basic element of the language, such as a word, number, or operator. Structure of a statement is the way the tokens are arranged together. Programming languages, like Python, are formal languages designed to express computation. Although formal and natural languages have many features in common, such as token, structure, syntax, and semantic, there are some important differences. Formal languages have some important advantages over natural languages. First, they are unambiguous. Natural languages are full of ambiguity that people deal with the use of conceptual clues and other information. Formal languages are designed to be nearly or completely unambiguous, which means that any statement that has exactly one meaning regardless of context. Conciseness. In order to make up for ambiguity and reduce misunderstanding, natural languages employ a lot of redundancy. As a result, they are often verbose. Whereas formal languages have less redundant information and therefore are more concise. But finally, literalness. Natural languages are full of idioms and metaphors. If I say the penny dropped, there is probably no penny and nothing is dropping. Formal languages mean exactly what they say. Python is unambiguous. That means programs have only one meaning. If the output is not what you expected, it means you did not implement properly what you meant. Programming is prone to error. Three kinds of error can occur in a program: syntax error, runtime error, and semantic error. Syntax error, that's where Python can only execute a program if the syntax is correct. Otherwise, the interpreter displays an error message. In this example, the first instruction is built correctly and the result is displayed. However, the second instruction is missing an opening bracket and the interpreter does not understand what you meant. In this case, the interpreter raises a syntax error. The second type of error is runtime error, so-called because the error does not appear until after the program has started running. In this case, the syntax of your code is correct, but something bad has happened. These errors are so-called exceptions because they usually indicate that something exceptional has happened. Finally, the third type of error is the semantic error. Semantic errors are errors where the program runs successfully to completion. However, for some input, it will not generate the right solution. If there is a semantic error in your program, it will run successfully in the sense that the computer will not generate any error message. But it will not do what you expected. It will do something else. Specifically, it will do what you told it to do. The issue is that the program you wrote is not the program you wanted to write. The meaning of the program, or in other words, its semantic, is wrong. Semantic errors are the most challenging one to debug. Debug means to find and resolve an error in a program. Identifying semantic error can be tricky because it requires you to work backward by looking at the output of the program and trying to figure out what it is doing. A computational process in a correctly working computer executes program precisely and accurately. In other words, a correctly working computer will always do what you tell them to do. So if a program doesn't work, it is your fault. Let's have a quick look at the Python programming language. The programming language you will learn this term is Python, a high-level language. Loosely speaking, computers can only execute programs written in low-level languages, also referred as machine language or assembly language. So programs written in high-level language must be processed before they can run. Two kinds of programs process high-level language into low-level languages: interpreters and compilers. This extra processing takes some time, which is a small disadvantage of high-level languages. However, the advantages are enormous. Firstly, it is much easier for a human to program in a high-level language. Programs written in high-level language take less time to write. They are shorter and easier to read, and they are more likely to be correct. Secondly, programs written using high-level language are portable, meaning that they can run on different kinds of computers with few or no modification. A program written in a low-level language can run only on one kind of computer and has to be rewritten to run on a different kind of computer. Due to these advantages, almost all programs are written in high-level languages. Low-level languages are used only for a few specialized applications. An interpreter reads a file containing the program written in high-level language and executes it. It processes the program a little at a time, alternating reading lines and performing computation. So the first step is to write the source code, and then call the interpreter on this source code. The interpreter reads the source code and produces the output. A compiler, on the other hand, reads a program and translates it completely before the program starts running. In this context, the high-level language program is called the source code, and the translated program is called the object code or the executable. Once a program is compiled, you can execute it repeatedly without further translation. This extra processing takes some time, which is one, albeit a small, disadvantage of the high-level language. For some large projects, compiling the source code from scratch can take several hours. Python is considered an interpreted language. There are two ways to use the interpreter: in interactive mode and in script mode. In interactive mode, you type a Python statement and the interpreter displays the result of the instruction. The chevron is a prompt the interpreter uses to indicate that it is ready for instruction. If you type 1 plus 1, the interpreter displays the result of the evaluation of this expression in this example, the value 2. Similarly, you can use a print statement to print a result of an operation. And in this example, a string that is the text Bonjour le monde. Once the statement is executed, we can see the string printed on the interpreter prompt. In script mode, you store the code in a file and use the interpreter to execute the content of the file, which is called a script. By convention, Python scripts have names that end with the extension .py. Here, in the file helloworld.py, we wrote a single statement, print Bonjour le monde. To execute the script, you have to open a terminal to run the interpreter. Then you have to tell the interpreter, Python, the name of the file to execute. In our example, the script is contained in the file helloworld.py. Once executed, the output is displayed on the terminal. Usually, you will be working in script mode. Sometimes, working in interactive mode is convenient for testing small pieces of code because you can type and execute them immediately. For anything more than a few lines, you should save your code as a script so you can modify it and execute it in the future. Now that you have a better understanding of what programs and programming languages are, the next step is to learn the Python syntax.